opened his right eye and looked towards him. Then Mahaprabhu told, I want to hear something. प्रभु कहे बड़ा श्लोक साध्य निर्णय. I want to know this. What is the goal of life and what is the process? But I want that you should give evidence from your shastra. Oh, I don't want to see to hear anything beyond shastra. So you should present any proof. Especially Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, and all plans. Wait and then I will believe. If anyone is very high class of devotee, very high, and is chanting and remembering, but not in a process told by Shastra, then what is distance. All distance. We cannot be successful. So you should not be. Try to come in process. Accepting any good guru. Don't accept bogus guru. If you, anyhow you have accepted him, then is that? And again, you should take. So take any good qualified, oh, who is following, always following Shastra. He should have served his own guru. And if he had not served his guru and not followed his guru, don't go to him if he knows all Shastra. He is Param Pandit. He is so qualified, remembering Ved, Upanishad, Shastra. Don't go. Like Ramchandra Puri, he accepted a guru, but he never served as he wanted. Don't go to Ramchandra Puri. Go to Ishwar Puri Pad. Go to Raghunath Das Goswami. He has served his guru in a line. So, like this, a guru has not served fully to his Gurudev, and he is not in his line. Control. Assuage it. And you should reflect. And take a new qualifier and thus if he is renounced from worldly desires, sense gratification, he attends the enchanting name always. He knows all the shastra. And some realization. So you should go and take shelter. If you have been initiated by a high class of guru, but he passed away, and you are not fortunate to be and hear his old teachings, then as a shiksha guru, you can accept any high class of guru. Always be in high class of association. If you are not doing, you are bound to go. So you should do. Follow all these things. I know, or you know all, Ishwar Puripad, Ishwar Puripad has a disciple named Govinda. And he was passing away from this world. He told to his disciple, dear disciple, and he was of scheduled caste. He told that at once you should go after my passing. You go to Sri Chaitanya, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is in Puri, and you should serve him. And take him as Shiksha Guru, your guru, not less than me. And he went there. Oh, when he went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, And he told that my Gurudev, Ishwar Puripad has sent me to you, Tushar. Oh. Quickly, he embraced him and told, yes, this would shut me. And we all said, all were in doubt, so many devotees. Even this is scheduled, is of scheduled caste. But Chaitanya, why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is accepted me? And he is cooking, he is bringing Mahaprasadam, doing everything top to bottom. And especially they had doubt that why Ishwar Puripad accepted. Then Mahaprabhu told that he was Ishwar. Ishwar Puripad was?
Independent.
Ishwar. Not even in control of Ved, Upanishad or anything. He is out of control like Krishna. So he accepted. In his life there is no scheduled caste or high caste. Everyone is the eternal servant of Krishna. So he accepted. And I also, I am bound to accept my Gurudev order. And he accepted. So we should try to know all these things. So he is telling what I was telling. Then he told, oh, I was telling about evidence. If Guru is not, have no evidence of Shastra, oh, we cannot accept him. Never. He should follow the line of Shastra. He should be ideal in Shastra. Is all what?
Realization.
And his life should be in that way. If he is not following Gita, Bhagavat, Ramayana, Puran, Shastra, Upanishad, Ved, oh, actually he is not good. So we should see, and just then we should offer our life in that way. But anyhow, if you have given to a bogus guru, and now you are realizing that he cannot help, he has himself fallen down, at once quickly, without wasting your single minute, you should accept any high class of Shiksha Guru or Diksha. So he is telling, Raya kahe, स्वधर्म आचरण विष्णु भक्ति है वर्णाश्रम आचार बता उसे न परम कुमार विष्णु आराध्य के पंथा न संतोष कारण पंडित मिने जो वेरी क्विकली
श्री चैतन्य चैतन्यमृत मैं डिलीवर चैप्टर 8 टेक्स्ट 58 Translation by Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Vishnu, is worshipped by the proper execution of prescribed duties in the system of Varna and Ashram. There is no other way to satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. One must be situated in the institution of the four Varnas and Ashrams.
Here,
Ranamananda.
He's telling two things, goal of the life and the process goal. What is goal? Goal is mukti, liberation, or happiness of this world, sense gratification of this world. And what is the process? Process, not our exercise, mental air. Body action. Not karma. Karma is always what? Apakram. Karma. What we are doing, jobs and these are karma. Even satkarma. All meant dirty. You cannot be cured by these dirty words. Like an elephant. He takes bath in Ganges. And at once he took so much dust from
iceberg
for If anyone is dirty and he is taking bath in dirty water, no fruit. So these fruitive kams are always dirty. Or they cannot help. Always some distress will come to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If that karma is to please Krishna, even that Varnasham Dharma, Varnasham Dharma has been established by Krishna himself. So that we will be favorable. And then we can be happy. So if that fruity karma are offered to Krishna, to please Krishna and Varnasham Dharma we follow, then that goal can be achieved. What goal? Material gratification, sense gratification or swarga, even. Mahaprabhu told. But you bhajya geta. This is very important. We have nothing to do with this. By which all the purpose cannot be solved. This is not related to eternal religious. Now, what is this? By this, if you are king, like just now we talked about Kailas, or Raman, or Kumbhakarna, or Pradhan Maharaj Chaudhar, Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyakashipu. So Varnasham Dharma, even though you are farming, but not helping so much. So, someone tells like that Swamiji, his Guru Prabhupada came to establish Varnasham Dharma and we should be in Varnasham. It was his barrier.
External.
Then Raya, he told. Some other thing. Then Raya kahe Krishna karma arpana sarva 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 sarva. For he was not satisfied, then again he told, what we are doing, whatever we are doing, fruitive karmas, Varnasham Dharma, we should try to offer to Krishna. And for this, he presented it, a Gita slope, evident, yat karosi, yadasnasi, yat jahosi, yadasi, yat, yat tapasyas kaunteya, tat kuruswamara. What meaning?
O son of Kunti, all that you do, all that you eat, all that you offer and give away, as well as all austerities that you may perform, should be done as an offering to me, Krishna told Arjuna.
Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, oh, it is also external. Oh, go on. And then he told, what he told? Rai kahe, swadharma tyag, ei shabdasa. Don't do dharma and don't do adharma. What you should do? Swadharma tyag. What is the meaning?
This is also external, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Rai Ramananda Rai replied, to give up one's occupational duties in the Varnashram is the essence of perfection.
Why?
Because then you don't have to suffer. It's a way for relief, so it's again for personal.
If you are offering all your things,
if you
giving Swadharma,
if you think it's yours, there's a harm right there because you don't realize that it belongs to Krishna.
When anyone is doing an activity and offering it to Krishna, then they have a misconception. That is false ego. I am the controller, I am the doer, I am the owner, and all of these things I am offering to Krishna.
You are a fruitive karma. Never and never. In a moment you can die. In a moment you can be mad. So you are not doer, only by the wish of Krishna. And Krishna has given this body. And when he will wish, you can dwell in it. Otherwise, never. So, you are not doer. If you are doer, then all this is bogus. So Mahaprabhu told that. Oh, give up this idea. You should go on. And then he told, oh, for this he gave two shlokas. Agyayema gunana doshan vayadishtan swakam dharmam santajya jasarman mahabhade sarvadharmana parityajya
aham dvamsarvadhyo.
Try to hear. Oh, open your eyes and see towards me. Don't sleep or don't think anything.
Don't go in trance. We are in LA, not in France.
Giving up all types of religion and occupational duties. Mam ekam sharanam vaja. Come to me alone, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and take shelter. Aham tvam sarva papibhyo. I shall free you from all your reactions to your karma, to your sins. Moksha shami, and I will liberate you. Masucha, don't fear.
What is that?
Harmonious.
Sins?
Sins, pa.
What he will do?
He will burn them away. He will.
What
is the sin? Oh, here, this is the sarvapa, all of these reactions from your sinful activities.
Why Krishna is telling that? Oh, I will add a little for your all kinds of sins. So don't fear for the sins you have done. What sins he has done, that is what was that?
If you give up your religious duties, this may be the point.
So, very, very small children are there. And if you are giving, they may die. Oh, very beautiful, sweet wife. Very young age. And if you are giving, what she will do? Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left his Vishnu Kriya Devi. And mother and father are old and you have left your house. And left your all responsibility. And went away in the forest to chant Krishna. What is this? Oh, if you are hearing for this. At once you should give up all kinds of dhana that I have told to you. And take my shelter. I'm responsible for all these things. Don't be worried. I'll excuse what offenses or sins or this responsibility you have done, I will excuse
from
this. But is still Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told what? Oh? Yo Bhajya. Why he told you, Radhana? Why he told you about you? This is very good to take shelter in the Lord feet of Krishna. Why he told that it is bad? It is not good.
Because he's talking about completely surrendering to Krishna.
What louder?
This is one of the highest teachings in Bhagavad Gita, but Srimad Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was rejected as external because he's talking about giving up all external activities and surrendering to Krishna.
Not so fast. Not so much fast, my dear friend.
So this has been rejected as external because Sarva Dharma Pititaja is talking about giving up all one's responsibilities in this world and surrendering to Krishna, but still the platform of service has not been attained. So no service is being rendered, only surrendering, saranagati. We have heard that saranagati itself is not bhakti, but simply the doorway to bhakti. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is asking, oh, if you can speak higher than this, then you should talk higher, speak more.
In this slok, Krishna instructs Sarvadharma Pitya, give up all your duties in this material world and surrender unto me. The fault that is in this is that simply by giving up one's material activities does not begin one's spiritual activities in devotional service that has not been established. So therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Vairananda to go on and speak more.
Understand? This, oh, giving up and taking shelter of Krishna. Why you are taking shelter of Krishna? Oh, Prabhu, I have done so many bad things. Oh, please, that's good. There is no relation with eternal mood. Nothing. So, here, Krishna, Mahaprabhu is telling himself that give up this too. We have no need of doing all this. Oh, only you should chant and remember, be a very high class of devotee. Nothing to do with this. For others, Krishna has established these to do in Gita. And this is the perhaps the highest class of shiksha for all devotees in beginning. But even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did that. Because it has no relation with any
soul.
Our soul, activities of any soul. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that gone. Then Raya kahe gyan visha bhakti sadhisha. More so here. He told gyan visha bhakti. And he quoted a shloka of Gita. Brahma bhuta prasannatma. न शोचते न कांक्षते समासर्वेषु भूतेषु मद्भक्तिं लभते वेरी गुड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग
Ramananda Roy continues, according to Bhagavad Gita, one who is thus transcendentally situated at once realizes the supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed to every living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me.
Who is Brahma Bhuta? Who is Brahma Bhuta?
Here in this verse, Krishna is mentioning Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. When one is freed from the bodily conception of life, then he realizes, I am the soul, I am eternal, I am not part of this material world. Yet in this verse, no reference has been made to service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Srimad Bhagavatam gives the conclusion, Naiskamyam apichuta bhava shobitam nagyanam niranjanam kutapuna shashvara badamishare nachaptam kama yadapya karanam. Even if knowledge is pure and transcendental, yet it is devoid of a conception of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and service to Him, then it is not very attractive or perfect. So here, as someone who is liberated from the bodily concept of life, they may have the chance to attain bhakti. But here it's not described what that bhakti is or how it can be attained through association with pure devotees.
That is why Mahaprabhu rejected this highest class of shloka of Srimad Gita. Oh, your Gurudev also. He told that you should follow Gita. This is the base of the platform. We must, in first stage, we should follow. But after this, if you have tasted Hari Katha, and you have tasted to hear the sweet pastimes of Krishna, then you can reject this philosophy of Gita. Gita is essence of all Upanishad. But Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all the way Puran Shastra happens. Nidana Kalpataru Galita. Rasamalayam Muraho Mushrasika. Amen. One shloka of Srimad Bhagavati, if you have heard. And you have taste in hearing and to know, curiosity to know the meaning. What is the meaning? Deep meaning. Oh, you have passed the examination of Gita. Now you should begin and try to enter in the realm of bhakti, pure rasa bhakti. So Mahaprabhu told, rejected also. And then he told that you should go on. Then what he told? Rakai gyan sunya bhakti sattha sattva. He told that. Oh, but there is no gyan, no karma, no covering of gyan and karma. Anna bilasita sunyam, jnana karma adhi anandhutam. So this is sattya sattva. And this is the goal of all life. Jnani prayasamudupasyanamandeva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam thane sita sudivatam tanvam manovir. He prayed so Ajita Jito Apitrai Hatrai
Dokram. What is it? Roy Ramananda continued, Lord Brahma said, my dear Lord, those devotees who have thrown away the impersonal conception of the Absolute and have therefore abandoned discussing empiric philosophical truths should hear from self-realized devotees about your holy name, form, pastimes and qualities. They should completely follow the principles of devotional service and remain free from illicit sex, gambling, intoxication and animal slaughter. Surrendering themselves fully with body, words and mind, they can live in any ashram or social status. Indeed, you are conquered by such persons, although you are always unconquerable.
Ego or this can be also. What can be also?
Maybe.
And he was not satisfied with his heart and he was not happy. But anyhow, but there is no jnana, karma, to cover Krishna bhakti. Jnana and karma will have to follow till your life is, you are bound. But this should be favorable to bhakti. There should be children to bhakti, not that covering bhakti. So we should know what karma and what kind of jnana is favorable for bhakti. And those karmas and jnana, those who are not favorable, we should keep out all this. Then you can know this. So wherever you are, either in first family life, or in
renounce order,
like a brahmachari, or banaprasthi, or grihastha, or brahmachari. No, you should be there. What do? Thane sita tanvang manovi, prize word. Oh, always hear the sweet glorification of Krishna, pastimes of Krishna, very powerful. They will remove all your unwanted things very soon. So you should hear the past concepts of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, or Radha and Krishna Kanju. And if you want to test it all very soon, then you should try to hear the glorifications and the process of and life of bhakta. Like Ramanath Das Goswami, like Rupa Goswami, Sri Goswami, and all our acharyas. You can hear the pastimes of Prahlad Maharaj in the beginning, also Lal Charitra, Pitraketu Maharaj Upakhyan, and all. And Jagai Madhai dear, and others, especially Rupa and Ramanath. Very quickly you can attend this. Very true. So he is telling, oh, ज्ञाने प्रयास समुद्रपाश्य नहंते ये वजीवंत सुमन खरितां और ये वातां स्थाने स्थिताः सन्मा और यू शुड बी वेर यू आर एंड ऑलवेज हियर ग्लोरीफाइड वर्ड एंड यू गो टू दिस काउंसिल ऑफ हियरिंग लाइक दिस यू शुड डू प्रणाम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज हु आर हियर एस्पेशली टू दैट पर्सन हु इज गिविंग और हरि कथा श्री and to the place where it is going out. And those who are organizing for do pranam. By what? By tongue, by body,
and by mind.
Shastan. Like Hanuman, he used to do. Like Prahlad, like all. Also like Rupa Goswami, he used to do. Or he used to do pranam to all. So you should also. No friction will be there. Always all to all. And here, very presently. Here to not to only hear. How to? How you should hear? To follow, totally. If you are not going so deep, then against serve any high class of devotee. Otherwise you will understand what he wants to tell you cannot. You can do opposite. You cannot go. So Mahaprabhu. Oh. Very good. It is something. But go pranam.
Hari.
I will myself invite you all to be in class at 5 here tomorrow also. And we wish to try to keep this. Oh. Raman Sambhav in a very deep way.